that something?
Hey, Paul. I'm getting kind of tired of digging this hole. Can't we start a new one?
What's that? What do you mean, what for? We've been digging in this one for 2 months already, Pa. We ain't struck nothing yet but a lot of hard work.
Son, I've been digging this land close to 15 years, and I'm aiming to dig 15 more if need be. Trouble with you, boy, that you ain't found a patience that I got.
You don't need no patience. What we need is a diviner.
There you go again, talking superstition. All you talk about is diviners and conjures and stuff like that. Son, that ain't anything to worry with superstition. Now, you take me. I'm scientific.
You're so scientific, Pa. Why don't you get us a digging machine, Paul, and get the job done?
I ain't gonna buy nothing that costs money. I can't afford it.
Where you going, son?
Well, I'm quitting for the day, Paul. I'll wash up and go to town.
Never get rich that way.
Oh, Paul, I don't aim to get rich. I'm too young.
I'm worried about that, boy. What's he gonna see in town?
Well, we ain't particular. Anything that skirts on.
He ain't used to women yet. They can do him harm. He won't know about it till it's too late to stop the clock.
Hey, I brought you men some nice cool lemonade.
Why, I think you're doing it more.
What you got for dinner, honey?
Same as yesterday, bud. Bacon, fat, and grits.
I'd like me some fried chicken.
A man has a wife like Griselda. I don't know how he can keep his mind on food all the time.
Now quit your teasing, Tata.
If the good Lord seemed fit to put a beauty like you in our house, I'm going to take my fill of looking while I can.
Son, you don't know how lucky you are.
How am I lucky? Because I got a wife who don't love me?
What you two lovebirds got to argue about?
I never argue with Buck.
No, she hardly talks to me anymore. Too busy daydreaming about Will Thompson.
If you quit throwing his name up to me, maybe I get a chance to forget him.
All Will has to do is snap his fingers and you go running.
You keep on this way, Buck, and you wake up some fine morning all by your lonesome.
You don't mean that, Griselda.
No, Buck, you don't mean that.
You tell him I want to hear mention Will Thompson, I'll get him.
Sure don't know how to talk to a woman. Shelly ain't just another woman. She seems fit to marry you. And you think that's all you had to do to keep her happy for her?
I know what the trouble is. She's still thinking of Will. Here nearly a year, and you see me digging, and you didn't know what I was digging for.
I figured you're looking for water.
Water? Bruno, you think I'm going clean out of my head? I'm digging for gold.
Gold? In the state of Georgia?
Bright yellow gold. Gold coins. Big round of biscuit. Thousands of them.
Is that a fact?
Yeah, gold spoons, gold plates, gold forks.
Gold thunderbugs, you wouldn't be surprised.
You seen them for a fact?
Almost.
What?
Don't know exactly. I ain't finding it.
There. Grandpa told me about it. He willed to tell me the very day he died.
mistaken.
Make my dead grandpa to be alive.
No, I wouldn't do nothing like that.
In any world I can't stand, it's a lie.
You've got it, Vic. Ain't found no gold yet. What you folks need is an albiner to help you out. Why they tell me a man ain't got much chance of a snowball in hell? Why an albiner to help him find something?
What?
An albino.
What in the blue perfect hell is that?
Why is one of these all white men? Looks like they're made out of chalk. White as cotton. Got white hair, white skin, white eyeballs even. You fellas need them. Need them bad.
No, I'm scientific all the way through. I wouldn't have nothing to do with conjure.
But I ain't talking about no conjure, Ty-Ty. I'm talking about an albino. Why, they got a secret power. They can see right through the ground. Like was glass of water. Strictly scientific.
Convinced. You've got me convinced? Where's he at?
Well, he's expecting to be down with
Swan. Well, let's go. Come on.
The real honest to call albino. Really, the damn wrong. You think we can catch him?
Don't you worry none about that. We can't hold him and let him fly around and do the trick.
Hey, now don't forget. This albino is a citizen and a voter. You tie him up. Be sure you don't do nothing to break the law. But if you do, mention me out, because there's a future sheriff of this county.
Just how big a man is he?
Well, it's not how big he is that counts. It's the whiteness of him. His blood is white. The wax in his ears is white.
Thank God I'm gonna get that old white man of a hand to bust the gut in there. Fuck! You get on up in the house. Pick up the automobile for a little shit. Make sure the tires are up hot and dry. It was plenty of water in the rain. We'll be spending our lives when we get back. Yeah. Sure great for you for that time, Jim. Get you out of here. You don't mind taking the weather like this? I sure am grateful you came by here today, Pluto. Yeah. You open my eyes to where I've been missing an albino to show me exactly where that goat is buried. White hair boy can do it, can't he? Just like you said?
Well, sure he can. Albino, I reckon, can find most anything. Well, he might just walk right out into that field right there. Look right down through the ground. See where all that gold is buried.
Right there?
Anywhere.
Yes, man, I promised this piece of land to the Holiness Church. Everything that grows here, they can have. Cotton, corn, anything else.
Well, if that ground's so sacred, what do you take the cross out for?
It just occurred to me, Pluto. I never had gone down the whole God's little leg, and I know all these years. But suppose, like you said, that albino walks out of my farm and points to that land there. Those are gold buried right in that lot. Been there all the time. I'd be compelled by my conscience to give all that gold away to the preacher. Worse yet, maybe I wouldn't give him back. You never can tell. I'm a religious man, but I wouldn't stand for that.
Well, what are you going to do with it?
I'm going to move God's little acre. The spot where it don't stand out in the open is a sin and a temptation. Myself out of temptation. I found gold way up there, and I've been sorely tempted not to turn it over to you. You wouldn't want me in temptation, I know that. I don't mean to cheat you none. Oh, no, I don't. You can have anything that grows on this piece of ground. Flowers or honey or anything else. Daughter-in-law, is that watermelon cool and ripe and ready to eat?
Joy is fine.
yourself running for Sheriff Pluto. It ain't worth it. Come on. What did you want to talk to me about, Pluto?
Well, it's about your girl, sir.
Which one? I got three. All beautiful. The glory of the world.
Well, I agree to that, sir.
Pluto,
Squid,
you know something? Your eyes look just like watermelon seeds.
Yeah,
I can't help it, Mr. Squid. Your eyes are so small and your face is so red. You do, you look exactly like a watermelon with two seeds showing.
Now, Pluto, about my girl. They wrote it. She lives in Peachtree Valley. It's too far away to do you any good. And she's married besides to Will Thompson. Then it's over. Of course, she's married too. I sometimes wonder if Buck is a right and proper husband for a girl as beautiful as Griselda. Even if he is my own flesh and blood. So, that leaves my baby, Darn Jill. But she's too young to go courting.
I don't want to court her. I want to marry her.
You would, Pluto? You mean it?
I'd cut off my right arm to marry her.
You taking a liking to it, Pluto?
I sure to God have, and that's a fact. Only one thing kind of bothers me.
What's that?
Well, I heard she been teasing and fooling around with a lot of men. I heard.
Why, I'm tickled to death to hear that. Darling Jill is a baby of the family, and she's grown up at last.
She sure has. It's a pity God can't make a woman like Darling Jill and leave off before it goes too far. He just didn't know when he made enough of a good thing. He just kept on and on. Now, look at her.
Bear no mind, look. Darling Jill likes to tease something. That's only natural. The way I see it, woman's got to tease something before they settle down to bed and babies. It's a lot better to do it now than after get married. She'll change, Pluto. And it's up to you to satisfy and make her so happy that she'll leave off with everybody but you.
Hey, Pa, you know what Pa's already? Why don't we just go, Pa?
We're waiting for Darling Jill.
Pa, Darling Jill won't be back when she rides old Pluto's truck and some ditch.
Oh.
Mm. It's 12 hours to that swamp in the back. What I'd like to do is get that albino and get back here so I can go to town.
Son, I'm mighty proud to hear you say you want to be up and doing. Too many people in this world just want to sit around their butts and wait for the corn to grow. Well, not me and not my sons. We're in a hurry to get rich. Give me a cop, Sean. Pluto, I want to ask you a favor.
Well, I can't do no favors without my car.
Don Jill's going to bring your car back, you know that. And when she does, I want you to drive her to Peach Street Valley.
What about me, Pa? I want to go, too. I don't want to hang around here everlastingly waiting for something to happen.
You stay here.
I'll go if I please to go.
Can't wait to see Will again, can you? What'd I just get through telling you, bud? She goes to see Will Thompson over my dead body. I want you to stay here, Griselda, and cook us a mess of food. Wait for us to come back. You tell Darren Jill to go to Peachtree Valley and get Rosalind, her husband Will, and come back to the farm where she was born. I want my whole family together when we turn that albino loose and locate my grandpa's gold and make us all rich again. Will you help me, Pluto?
I reckon I can if you'll let me be your son-in-law.
Ain't up to me, Pluto. That ain't even up to Darren Jill. That's up to you. Get your car going, Buck. I'm not going until she promises to stay here.
I'm not promising anything.
Now, Buck, why don't you use your charm? Ask her nicely. Ask her. It won't hurt you. I'm asking you to stay, Griselda.
You asking me or telling me?
He's asking you.
Let him say it.
I'm asking you, Griselda.
All right. I'll stay.
Let's go, Paul.
Don't forget to get that out of jail when I told you.
Well, what do I have to do that for, Don Jill?
Come on, say so, you big horsehead.
All right.
Now, come straight ahead. Oh, that. That's it.
Your paw been digging any of those holes around here?
Now, I'm watching you. Don't worry about it. Okay, come on.
Jill, I don't even know what I'm doing here. This ain't even a right state for me to get elected, let alone the right county. It is hot.
No, Don Jill.
Don't you think they'd have found
long for now. Why can't Pa quit digging that land full of holes and try to raise corn or cotton or peanuts like everybody else does?
Well, I don't know about that, but Pa wants you and Will to come home, Rosemary.
Will? Will won't dig on no farm. He's not a farm boy. Pa know that by this time. Besides, I don't even know if Will's coming home tonight.
Well, then we'll just sit here and wait for him. We'll spend the night.
That's a mighty fine idea. We'll spend the night.
Not quite so fine, all right.
I'm going to sleep you on the bed with Rosamond, and you make yourself a pallet on the floor.
Oh.
Darling Jill, you here. Stand up. Let me look at you in the light. Well, well, and baby's a full-grown woman. Plump as a peach on a branch, and ripe and ready to pluck.
Will, don't take on that way. You got company.
Bruno, how you doing, man? Looking bigger and better than ever.
How are you, Mr. Thompson? You sure look like everything just fine with you.
Well, it ain't. Slip away, will you? Ain't that a sneaky thing to do? Come back here, all of you, and keep me company. How's Giselle?
She's still married.
You know, Pluto, I bought Giselle the first pair of high-heeled shoes she ever wore.
Well, bet me. Why don't you go to sleep?
When Giselle was working in the mill and she walked around in them high-heeled shoes, there wasn't a man got a full day's work done.
Well, please don't talk about it now.
The girl Griselda Pluto, we almost got married. Well, she wanted me to go root and grub on the farm. I wouldn't do it. I'm a town boy. I gotta be where I can hear a factory whistle blow three times a day. And watch those crowds of girls come running out of the company gate. Laughing, screaming, raising cane. Faces like flowers.
Will, you gotta realize something once and for all. That mill ain't never gonna open again. And Griselda's married. Can't do nothing about it. Come on. Come on. What's done is done. Now go to sleep.
I can't sleep.
Well, you can rest. Turn out the light so it won't hurt your eyes.
Connected. All it takes is for somebody to pull a switch on.
That's crazy talk, Will. Now, why don't you go home before your wife has to come looking for you here?
Don't tell me what to do. I know what I have to do.
What do you say you go down to Ned's bar and get yourself a drink? Here, have it on me.
Yes. Yes. How's my albino?
He's sleeping like a baby, Mr. Cockeye.
Morning, Dave. You sleep well?
Where am I?
You with friends. We went to a lot of fuss and bother to get you. Sure hope that you appreciate it.
I'm hungry.
You get your breakfast in due time. First, you got work to do.
What kind of work?
It's easy. I'll show you. You take this willow fork, and you hold it like that. Till she pulls you down, scientifically speaking, right down to where the gold is surely located.
Gold?
Are you looking for gold?
Why do you think we come clean down to Swamp Corners to lay a suit you?
I still don't know.
You're a genuine albino.
Yeah, I reckon I am.
What would I be doing with an albino except to find gold?
I ain't gonna do it.
Why not, son?
Because I don't know how.
You don't know how? You're a genuine affair, and you don't even know, Mr. Cockeye.
Let him loose, Mr. Cockeye. Now, you listen to me, son. If you don't know how to define gold, you better start learning right now. All these nice folks are going to be pretty mad at you, and we won't get no fiddles this winter.
I just can't. I can't.
I'm sorry I got angry, son. But I've been digging for gold for 15 years. And I ain't gonna give up.
I don't know what to do.
Well, it's easy now. I'll show you. See? You take this willow stick. That's it. Turn your wrist up. That's right. Put it out in front of you.
I tell you, you'll stop digging and start farming.
Now, wait a minute. Hey! I don't have a backlog. This is still by the lake, ain't it? So's the cold.
All right, no. I can't honestly say it is. A minute before Dave found the gold, something come over me. And I decided to change the location of God's lake.
just about in time, I reckon.
Where's it now, Pa?
Lord ain't told me yet.
Well, tell him to hurry. How about going to talk like that?
Good Lord and your Pa. We're old-fashioned. We got to take our time.
Unseasonable weather and all, I believe you'd admire to have your acre in a cooler spot. If you don't like this, you don't approve of what I'm doing, Lord. And strike me down dead right here where I stand.
Uncle?
No, but wait, but I'm on the way.
What are you stopping for?
Don't you? I've just got to have an answer.
Take a pin down my hair. Will you?
God almighty, don't you? I just got to know.
They can't hear nothing. I don't know if I'm ready to get married to anybody. Least of all, you.
You don't have to be ready. I'm ready. I'm ready enough for both of us. I'll marry you anytime, daytime, nighttime, all the time. I'm so crazy about you. That's a fact.
If that is
to be. Oh, don't you? You want a little thing like that come between us?
Now, if your belly wasn't so big, you couldn't be sheriff. And if you weren't going
to
be sheriff, I don't know if I even
looked
at you,
but
enough
to fight. Don't you? You had more to keep me like that. Just because I'm so crazy in love with you, I can't hardly see nothing else. There's no reason that someday I just don't get so riled up and so provoked that I just don't take my two hands and just...
And what told you?
Turn your heart. Turn your heart.
You're scared of the dog. I mean, for a minute, I thought you were going to darn your socks again.
Turn your heart.
Absolutely nothing, boys. Absolutely nothing.
Same old Ed.
Same old Ed.
What Will needs, Rosamund, is to occupy himself with something useful. You know, Will, there's nothing better for a man's body and spirit than digging down in God's good earth. Rosamund, you go in the house and help his other warm up the eats. Poor Pluto here, he's just about starving.
Well,
come on into the house, Pluto.
You know, nothing makes a man hungrier than having his whole family around.
Ma, That sure is a tremendous hole you dug. What's that? Can it boot?
Bet.
Yeah. Why, that's that old white man you put me on.
Great guns, Pluto! That's the albino we roped in the swamp!
Did he divine for you?
Just like four and four makes eight. Now you're going to house with rope.
Ty, Ty, this is absolutely crazy. Digging right beside the house, it's going to topple over into that hole.
It won't fall down. We kind of prop it up as we go along.
That's all that won't matter much. We strike gold, we'll be rich enough to build a house three times this size.
What are you looking at, Don?
Well, I'm looking to see that albino man. I never seen one before in my life.
Well, daughter, he's just the same as you and me.
Can he talk?
He talk you, I'm going to give him half a chance.
I want to see him just like Cole up here.
I don't even have nobody to fool with him. Just walk off and call Crows if that's what you got in mind. He's got to stay on the job for me all the time. Now, you come on into the house.
Well, I'm coming, Paul. Hello there, albino fella.
My name's Dave Dawson.
I sure am pleased to meet you. They sure didn't tell any lies about your color.
Yep, what?
Sure.
Mm.
Pretty color, too. I
like it. Thank you, ma'am. The first kind of words I've heard. Your pop kidnapped me with a string of lies and leather plow line.
Now that I got such a good look at you, would you like to come up here and get a good look at me?
Hmm? I don't mind.
What do you say?
You're beautiful.
Why don't you come on up here and say that again?
That'll get him shy and scared, Miss Darling Jill. He might run away. I don't feel like chasing after him with my shotgun.
Oh, he won't run away, Uncle Felix. I promise you that. Come on.
Come on. Dad, we're only gonna go out and watch Moonrise over the pond. Come on, come on, boy. Oh.
Don't you like me?
Oh, gosh, Amalia. I just didn't know there was a girl as pretty as you in the whole country. I mean, you're the prettiest girl I've ever seen. You know. Oh, and you're so soft. Yeah, you talk like a bird song. And you smell good, too.
Oh, I just love the way you talk. Talk to me for a moment.
What do you want me to say?
How come you're so quiet?
Well, I don't know. Some people say it's because I've made in the white of the moon.
Oh, I just think you're wonderful looking. I'm glad you're so different. I get so tired of the same looking people every day of my life. Would you like to kiss me?
Well, yeah, I would if you let me.
I reckon I just couldn't help myself.
Will you marry me?
Oh, now, I only said you could kiss me once. Oh, it wasn't me to pause and strap you up on that plow line and bring here. I'm awful glad that you
did. I recognize you, too.
Don't worry, Ty-Ty. Where's Dawn Jill? She's right here, man. Gone. My daddy's gone. Uncle Felix is gone. Now they got me worried.
Where's this here, Ty-Ty? Did she fell one of these holes?
We'll find it.
If I can't help it. They've been gone more than half an hour. Oh, an awful lot can happen in half an hour.
Just like what?
Well, like one thing, I don't know. Then another thing, maybe they just took off to another county and got mad.
Now you got me really worried. That Don Gill's crazy enough to do anything.
Don Gill! Don Gill, come home! Something's waiting! I'm waiting!
Tucker! Tucker, help!
Where are you?
Up there in the hole!
Which hole here?
This very deep one! You got me, Tucker!
I got you, Pluto. Come on! Come on, boy!
Tucker, why must you make this hole so deep?
Well, you know, Blue, in this pale moonlight, you can't see a thing.
Seems to me like these boys would have more sense than they tie egg them in a big and empty hole in the ground.
You got nothing but a lousy limp
head. Yeah, a lousy limp head.
There ain't no more gold in that ground than there is in the toes of my socks.
But your boys wise up and go to Atlanta, Augusta somewhere and get yourself a job to pay something Saturday night.
Why don't you soak your head in a gin bottle?
Soak your head in some gin bottle.
Yeah, stop, Buck. You too, Will.
Why don't you go back where you come from, limp head? Go back where you come from, you limp head.
I'll go back when I'm good and ready. Why don't you try to make me do it?
We'll make you.
We'll make you. Lynn, come on.
We'll make you.
Yeah, we'll make you.
Papa.
Drop that shovel, Buck.
Come on.
You do try to make
come on, you stinking head. Come on, all you lousy farm boys. Think you're tough. I don't care. You.
And talks like he's better than we are.
Yeah, that's why he comes over here, pie. He that little man, that's a beating.
Boys, it's a shame we can't keep a peaceful family. That's what I've been aiming all my life to have. And if I can't have it, I swear I'm going to leave that gold where it is and go back to grubbing cotton.
And you tell him to stop talking around my wife.
Griselda, in this?
I didn't say a word about it.
No, he don't say nothing. He just looks. And that's plenty.
Looks don't hurt anybody, but
he's getting ready to stop something. I know that much.
Griselda, you get in the house. Now, Buck, that's just your imagination. Will ain't after Griselda.
I will. I ain't made up my mind about that yet.
I'll kill him. I'll kill him.
You're going to kill nobody. Not on my land or any place else. Now you get up on the ground and cool off. Get all heated up down this hole and take fresh air to get it out of you. Now go on. Go out the house. Go on, Joe. Go on, Buck. Get it.
Tell him to go home.
Yeah, boy, tell him to go home.
Buck's right out of the room.
I hope you don't mean that, Will. Now I found the right spot. I'm going to need all the help I can get.
Right spot. The house's going to topple right into this hole if you dig any more. I gotta go home. I gotta get that meal started.
That ain't what you're thinking about. You're thinking about Griselda.
It ain't no sin to think.
Well, you're gonna kill yourself if you go on that way. Dave, are you sure you divined the gold in just the right place?
Well, you saw the willow point down, didn't you?
That's right. Willow don't lie. Why should it? Joe Santé.
Mr. Tartar, you ought to be out raising cotton. You are good for him. That is, you used to be. Mr. Tartar, you can raise more cotton on this land in one season than you can find gold in a whole lifetime. It's a waste of everything, Mr. Tartar, digging them holes all over the place.
Well, now, I wish I had spent more time on the cotton for sure. If I had 20 or 30 bales to tide me over the fall and winter, I could devote all the rest of my time to digging.
But, Mr. Tartar, where are we going to get enough grub to carry us through another winter?
We use my credit, like I did last winter.
The store man says you ain't got enough credit left to breathe the end of your nose.
Felix, I'm sorry about that, but there's nothing I can do. I just got to go on digging. I got the fever. You can't stop the fever.
Well, Mr. Tartar, if it's as bad as all that, why don't you go up to Augusta and borrow some money from your son, Jim Leslie?
Oh, there wouldn't be no sense in that.
Why not, Mr. Tartar? I dare tell he's rich. Anyhow, I ain't never heard of a cotton broker this fall.
All the same, he wouldn't help me none, Felix. My son, Jim Leslie, won't speak to me on the street. And if he won't speak to me on the street, I know darn well he won't lend me money.
You're his pappy, ain't you, Mr. Tonto?
I reckon so. Jim Leslie ain't been a bad man. He ain't been a good one. Like practically his friend.
And that's wrong. I'll go see him just to keep the family ties together. But I can't,
Felix. But Mr. Tonto, you just gotta get some money real quick. Else, how are you gonna keep us all on the farm? Why, we'll all have to go someplace else to work to make a living.
Just got a wonderful idea. I'm gonna call on Jim Leslie.
You know he's my son. He's a rich man. He's a cotton broker. And no son of mine's gonna stand by and let his team go hungry. Felix, now you act good over there. You hear me?
I hear you, Mr. Kaikai.
What are you doing? Oh, now you don't reckon I'm gonna run away from you? I've never been so happy in all my born days.
Now, son, you get up from there and get going.
You don't have to do what you say.
It ain't me that's talking, boy. It's this gun. Now, you get up and get going. And head straight for your home. Back to the swamp.
You know, you ain't gonna shoot me, are you?
I ain't gonna shoot nobody, son. But this gun might.
No, I don't wanna go.
I'm sorry, son, but you got to go. It's the only way I know how to save this swamp. Now, you get going.
Beautiful as a new Coca-Cola sign they're putting on a highway coming into Georgia. Oh, brother, time and patience it must have took to do that. Those leaves on the trees,
almost like real. Yeah, I don't know. We need a picture.
Spend a half dollar in gasoline, drive into the woods and see the real thing, nothing.
What are you doing here?
Now, son, you know you're pleased to see us. Don't put on that you're not.
Funny, I didn't hear any doorbell. We don't ring no bells in my family. We just walk in. I said, that's what we do in my family. We're never going to do any different. Nobody has to knock on my door. Ring no fancy bells to get in the house.
Well, what'd he come here for?
Money, I suppose.
Well, why don't you dig it out of the ground?
Is that a nice way to talk to your only dad?
Well, that's what you came here for, isn't it, money?
Not at all. All I need is the wherewithal to buy feed and seed for my sharecroppers so that I can dig down another 20 feet and locate my grandpa's gold.
Well, there's no gold there. You know that. You know it as well as I do. You ought to. You've been digging for 15 years. You'll be digging holes on the day you die.
There's the money. Now, take it and go on home. Something got into you, Jim Leslie. At an early age. You're different from the rest of us. I don't know why. You act like you're ashamed of me. Well, I don't see how that can be because I'm your father. But you take on like you don't know who I am or where you're from. Well, I'm sorry for you, son. You married a widow. Not because you loved her, just had to have her. Not because you got caught with the bases loaded by her pa. No, you got married just to get you a house and a fortune. Well, your wife's dead now. And all you got left is a house full of breakable dishes.
Son, I guess we better be going. Pa, why don't you fix yourself a drink? I don't take a drink, son. Well, there's some fresh fruit in the dining room. Why don't you go on and help yourself?
I don't mind if I do.
But you too, darling, Jill, Griselda. Go on in.
Dining room, way down there.
That's right, Paul, right down there.
I'm hungry. Griselda, sometime when you're in town, come up to see me. It's my office number. I want you to call.
I wouldn't do that.
Why not?
Because it isn't right, that's why.
I'm going to be looking for you just the same, Griselda. You're going to come up and see me.
No, I'm not.
I bet that's your only pair of shoes. You come up and see Jim Leslie, he'll buy you the whole shoe store. If you don't come see me, I'm going to come out there and get you here. I'm going to come out to that pig-belly farm and bring you right back to this house. You don't love Buck. If you did, you'd have four kids by now. But I wouldn't.
You're not pulling apart, Griselda. You've got to stop. I apologize for Jim Leslie, Griselda. My family ain't known for their politeness to women. They're headstrong that way. Come on.
I'll be coming out there and get you one of these days, Griselda.
Thanks for the money, son. Consider it a loan.
Did you get it, Paul? Did you get it?
I reckon I did. Just look at this big wad of greenbacks.
Hey, Paul, you know what I'd like to get now? I'd like to get me a raincoat.
What for?
Well, it's fixing the rain, Paul.
We can't rain now. I don't want to rain yet a while. I got digging that hole, and I can't dig underwater any too well.
Yeah, but, Paul, suppose it does rain. I'd like to put me on a raincoat.
Well, if it starts to rain, you just peel off your clothes and let your skin take care of the rest. God never made a finer raincoat than a man's skin anyhow.
Let's go. Besides, I'm kind of thirsty. We can stop in town and get a quick bid.
Well, I don't think it'd be showing the proper respect for Jim Leslie's money to spend it in a saloon.
Just one beer, Paul. One beer, Paul?
I never been in a saloon in my life, and I ain't going to start now.
Well, we're waiting to call, Paul.
Ooh.
do what I told you. You girls stop teasing. Don't take the boys out of that saloon.
Leave me be, woman. Griselda, get me out of here.
Hey, hey, leave up all alone. Your paw?
Well, who's your baby was?
Well, now, what do you mean honking your horn under my window?
I apologize, ma'am, but I was only trying to get my family out of that saloon.
Well, you made me come all the way down here for nothing. I'll hoodoo you, you toxic miser.
Hey, you girls, make that boy die.
He tried to drink Will under the table, and I guess he lost.
What a saloon can do for me.
Yeah, but I stuck the beer.
It's all a different proof. Keep drinking water right in our own backyard. Oh, my health and long life, it's just plain well water. Now you get Will and Rosamond, and we'll be on our way.
Huh? Hey, Will! Will Thompson! Hey, Rosamond! Come on, Will! Rosamond, come on!
Give me the power! I'll turn on the power! Give me the everlasting light of life! The power! How you beautiful!
Now, wait, you keep your hands off or you leave
here! I'll kiss my dear old wife!
You will not keep your hands off!
Go on away from me now!
Sorry, I had to do that, son, huh? Rosamond, you and Will have to go back to Peachtree Valley. I don't seem to be able to keep my family together.
Told me he went to Jim Leslie's house, and I went there. I seen Jim Leslie. He said, go to the first bar, come to, and he'd be there drinking up his money, whatever he mean. I like the Jim Leslie fella. I got his vote.
Oh, you everlasting hothead. Jim Leslie don't even live in the right county to make his vote count.
Is that a fact?
Bluto, I couldn't be happier to see you.
Is that a fact?
Yeah, you come at just about the right time.
I did?
You and Don Jill are going to drive Will and Rosamond back to Peachtree Valley.
Oh, no, not again.
Come on, let's walk.
Come on, Will. Let's get up and do it.
I'm going to pull the switch and light up the whole world tonight.
Yes, Will, yes, you can do it, honey. Everything's
going to
be all right.
Don't yes me like I'm a baby.
No, I'm not, honey.
I'm going to pull
Will,
a switch
Will,
and light up the whole world.
Honey,
leave me alone. I'm going to pull a switch and light up the whole world, Ty. I'm telling you.
Paul? Paul, I'm afraid to go back home. Will's not a chef. He's never been this fine. He's going to do something, I know. 6 months now, I've just been living day to day, hoping that tomorrow will change him. But I've got to have help now. I can't do it alone. Grizel, you're the only one he might listen to.
Now, Rosamond, honey. Now, Grizella, she can't go, honey.
Oh, please make Grizella listen to me.
Well, I'd ache for you, daughter, but Grizella has to make up her own mind.
Don't ask him. Who can I ask? Hates Will.
You hate him too?
No. You know I do.
You love him? Same as I do.
That's why you've got to help him, Grizella. Please. I'm begging you. Please. Please.
All right. I'll go with you till it's over.
Thank you, Grizella.
Sleeping, thank goodness. Here it is, Doc. I wasted another day. Haven't counted a single vote. I've got to be getting home. Sorry, this ice can get too cold to eat.
Wait just a little while longer.
till he wakes up. He's my father, peach ice cream. I've got to go too, Rose. My mom's going to be wild. Stay a while. I don't want to be here alone with him.
Are you scared, Will? Your own husband?
I reckon I am. Well, he's been acting lately.
Wait until I woke up, didn't you?
Yes, Will.
Turning on the power tonight.
Will, wouldn't you like some peach ice cream?
You never worked in a cotton mill, did you, Will?
No, sir. I've got to be getting home. I've got to get elected. It's mighty important, Will.
You know what it's like in a company town when there's no work?
No, sir.
Well, I'll tell you. You ever shoot a rabbit and go and pick him up? And when you lifted him up in your hand, felt his heart pounding? Like, I don't know. Have you? Well, I have. I have.
Where are you going?
Turn the power.
Oh, no. No. Get out of here. Somebody, please.
Seems the day I left. Waste. Nothing but waste. Griselda, the power's on the valley hums. There's meat and potatoes on every table. People, they remember funny things to laugh at. When the power's off, the valley's dead. You see what I mean, Griselda? You see why I got to turn on the power? Talking about it too long. Takes a man to turn on the power, not just a talker. Just looking at you makes me feel like a man again.
How can I help you, Will?
Look at me. Just keep looking at me.
Will, no.
You sound like Rosa.
People love you, Will.
Then help me, Griselda. If I don't do it now, I'll never do it.
I'll do anything you want, Will. Let's get out of here.
I've never been this close before.
Don't think about it, Will.
Thank you.
hospital. I'm not going without you. I know!
Everybody a nice two glass of water, you hear? Rosamund, why don't you just sit in the porch and rest a little?
Please, Buck.
Please what? Don't want me to talk about it, huh?
No, not talk about it. Anyway, you ought to have some regard for Rosamund.
What do you care about Rosamund?
Why did you have to chase that thing?
Griselda, we have to cook dinner.
No one's eaten in this house till I get an answer from her. I asked you a question. Can't you talk?
Sure, I can talk. But this isn't the time for it.
It's a shame you can't kill a man but once. Otherwise, I'd be gunning for him right now. I'd like to kill myself.
Now, Richard, you ought to be ashamed of yourself, Buck.
You shut up. You don't look ashamed for anything. You're both alike. A pair of loose fellas.
If you ain't man enough to hold on to your wife, I'd be ashamed to admit it. I'd just go hide my face someplace.
What did you say? I'm a fan. What?
Oh, Will's dead. Ain't that enough punishment?
We're going on like this all the time. And we're getting further and further away from the happy life.
Oh. Hey, Paul. Oh, I've been warning you, Paul.
All of us ought to sit down and think a little about this. And how to do it. God didn't put us here to scrap and fight each other all the time.
I don't want to hear no more about God.
We don't have a little more love for each other. There's going to be a real sorrow in your heart, son. I've tried all my life to keep a peaceful family under my roof. If you just stop fighting, learn to smile and laugh just a little.
You talk like an old fool.
Maybe it sounds that way to you. But you got the feeling of God in your heart. You just can't fight.
God, what did God ever do for you?
I don't feel exactly the way Buck does, but we ain't got a penny out of God's little lady here.
The boys don't seem to catch on. It's not important that I get money out of God's little lady. In fact, I can walk on it and stand on it. Feel God is there.
What's all this got to do with me and Griselda?
Well, you boys seem to think about it. The things you can see and touch. Well, that ain't living.
It's the things you feel down inside you.
That's what living's for. And if you felt more how Griselda feels inside her, no other man could touch her.
That's just what I was getting at before you shut your fool mouth off.
What went on between you and before he died? How's it going to make you feel any better to ever tell you that?
I want to hear from her. I got a right to that, haven't I?
I'm afraid to tell him,
Paul. No, don't tell him anything.
You stay out of that.
If I was you, when I went to bed tonight, I'd get down on my knees in the dark and try talking to God a little. He can tell you things nobody else can. And maybe he can tell you how you ought to act with Griselda. He'd tell you if you only take the time and trouble to listen. But if there's anything in the world he's crazy about, it's seeing a man and a woman in love with each other. And to forgive is part of love. When he sees that, he knows the world is running along as slick as grease.
Buck will come along all right when he gets to the Lord. You just try and be patient with him. Let him live a little longer. It seems to take some people almost a lifetime to learn some things. Buck is really young.
I'm afraid he'll never learn, Buck.
What's there to learn? Will wasn't any bigger than I am. He wasn't any strong either. I could throw him any morning before breakfast.
It wasn't the way he looked that made him different, Buck. It was the way he was made inside. He could feel things. And you can't.
You can't suck me in with that kind of talk. I want to know what you and Will did behind my back. Pluto, you were there. What happened?
Nothing much.
What do you mean by nothing much?
Nothing much just means nothing much, that's all.
Did you go deaf, dumb, and blind the day you went to Peachtree Valley?
Well, listen, Buck, I was in that house the whole time we're there. I didn't see nothing more exciting than coffee and cake and peach ice cream. Then that siren blew, and we all knew that Will was dead. That's a fact.
Now that's settled. Let's go in and get some supper. Come on, Rosamund. We'll all get a good night's rest, and tomorrow things will look a lot different.
Well, I'm going back to Augusta.
Careful, lift, Griselda. I got a big empty house. Oh, plenty of room for you too, Rosamund.
Now look here, son. You're welcome to stay for supper. If you're still all fired and getting back to Augusta, you go on. Don't be tempting the girls. They're staying here.
You know, it looks like all of you learned your lesson by now. All you raised on this land is piles of dirt and empty holes.
I aim to strike a load soon.
You've been saying the same thing for years. Age didn't bring you any more sense.
I got sense you don't know about, son.
I hate the smell of this place. I hated it since the day I was born. You can come live with me in Augusta, Griselda.
You can have some new clothes, a new car, plenty of spending money.
Get in the house, Griselda.
You can come live with me.
Hey, get your hands off! I'm coming out of here! I'm coming out of here!
Oh, my God.
The bottom dropped out from under me. I feel like I'm sinking. I can't help myself.
Don't talk like that, Bob. Don't talk like that.
It's all my fault, John. Take it for gold. Take it for gold. Never give it heed to my son. Till the God big enough to kill him, John. Augusta, where you belong. If you ever show your face here again, son of mine or no son of mine. Seeds for things to grow.
And you big horsehead of a sheriff's wife to be.
You plant well, Sean.
Yeah. Well, I'm planting.
Oh. What have we got for dinner, honey?
Thank you, Justin, about baked fat and bread.
I don't care. I just want to be weighed down by a beautiful woman.
Oh, hold it! Oh, here. What's the matter, Mr. Chai Chai?
Well, I've got something mean and hard.
It ain't nothing but a rock, Mr. Chai Chai.
It sounded like metal. That's what it did.
What'd you find?
Well, I can feel it. I can feel it. Give me room.
Why, it's nothing but an old shovel, Mr. Tata. Oh,
look at this shovel.
I bet you it's 100 years old. I bet you my grandpa used this shovel to bury the gold. It's a sign from the Lord. Mr. Tata, if we're going to have a crop this year, we got a whole lot more plowing to do here.
I don't reckon there'd be much time lost if I just took this day to give my grandpa one more chance. Huh, is that it?
Come on, you.